A spin transition like what we put in the opening can add endless fun to a video. In this tutorial, we are gonna show you how to use Video Prog Flagger to make the spin transition like this. If you are into this topic, keep watching. First, let's open Video Prog Flagger. Add the needed videos to the program. Then drag these videos onto overlay track in order. Feed each video to the screen. And based on our need, we can use the Ripple Edit tool to trim each clip for getting the proper duration. After all of this, we can start making the spin effect. First, let's click on the first video, hit Motion to enter the motion editor. Drag the playhead to the far right. Then hit the previous icon, move the playhead 5 to 8 frames forward, and hit Add Keyframe to add the first keyframe. Adjust the selection box to make it cover the entire screen. Then let's go to the last frame and add a second keyframe at this point. Now we can move the button to find a rotation. And herein we enter 90 degrees. Alternatively, drag the selection box to make it rotate around 90 degrees. Then let's go to speed. And choose Smooth Speed Up number 1. Next, let's make the motion effect for the second video. Enter the motion editor first. We add a keyframe at the first frame. Then adjust the selection box. We want it to fit to the screen size in the first place. Then, like what we did before, we enter the wanted angle into the input box of rotation. Give it caution, the angle value should be opposite from what we set for the first video. In my case, I rotate the first video 90 degrees. So here, I need to enter negative 90 degrees, and then hit next, and move the playhead for 5 to 8 frames forward. Add a second keyframe at this point. Adjust the selection box to make it select the entire screen. Then find the speed menu and choose Smooth Speed Down number 2 as the speed mode. That's how to make a spin effect. Then we do the same for editing the following videos. We've made the spin transition effect, but we might notice there are some unwanted black space when the videos are rotating. To improve the viewing experience, we can add a background. Add the videos we already used onto video track, trim them to make them the same length as the videos on the overlay track. Then go to the inspector panel on the right to find image blurring and smoothing. Select Enable Image Denoising and adjust the 3 parameters to the maximum for blurring the background. That's all for making a basic background. Surely, if we want to get a better result, we can do something we already did to make them rotate. But this time, we need to scale down the selection box. Give a caution, don't make the black background become visible, just like this. We keep editing the background for the rest of videos. Last, let's add some details. Let's import a white image clip and add a new overlay track. Adjust the duration of this clip and place it between two videos. And then we click on a picture clip, find Fit and Move. Select Fit In and Fit Out, and adjust the duration. That can bring us a flickery effect. Last, we add a background music and a sound effect. We've got the wanted outcome. That's all for today's tutorial. If you want to know more editing tricks or the latest news about Video Prague Flagger, be sure to click the subscribe button to subscribe if you haven't yet. See you in our next editing tutorial. Hope you enjoy it. Bye.